call upon our next guest of honor, Mr. Pramod Sharma. Mr. Sharma has had an experience of a career in education spanning 42 years. He has served as a principal for more than 25 years across various institutions. He has been awarded the National Award for Teachers in the year 2000 by the President of India. He is the ex-chairman of the Indian Public Schools Conference and the recipient of the Lifetime Achievement Award from IPSC in the year 2008. He is an honorary member of the Round Square and IPSC. Sir, we would love to hear
you. Thank you, Pranav, for EduTV to give us this chance to be together.
It's our pleasure, sir.
I have wanted to start by saying that when I was just out of school in the 70s, or when I started teaching, since then the world population has doubled. And today everyone knows, this is known statistics, that 50% of our population in this country is below 25. And 60% of population is above 30, is below 35. So that is a very unique opportunity that this country has, that so many people, young population is available. You just heard that how nobody is going to die. And the whole, all of the world, including Europe and even China, has aging population. So if nobody is going to die and these people, everybody has to age, then there are a lot of supports which are required for aging population. You can imagine all the careers. And in this country, we continue to spend between 2.5% to 3% of our annual budget for education. And this opportunity is being totally missed. We are in the process. Mandir kahan banega, but nobody is talking about how to skill this vast majority of population. Perhaps so many paramedical services will be required, so many physios will be required, so much in Medicare would be required if all of us have to live that long. So this is one gap that I wished to draw your attention. One notice has come from CBSE. I do not know whether you have whether you noticed it. It says that the examination centers will also conduct practical examination from next year. Have you noticed that?
Yes.
Fantastic. What does it mean? You see, in this country, I and my colleague, Captain B.K. Verma, we have been on CBSE board for over 10 years. And it is just an endorsing body. Whatever proposals used to come, we just used to endorse it. There's hardly any discussion. Am I right, sir?
Brilliant.
And for 10 years, I continue to say that the practical examination in this country has become fast. Total fast. We, from school to school, you can go across. Every school gives 28 marks out of 30 to those who do badly, 29 who are mediocre, 30 to those who are very bright and also very weak, so that they can compensate it with the pay grade. That is the situation. And if this is the situation, and then we talk about why no actual knowledge, research, as far as research is concerned, no actual knowledge is being created in IITs or in other engineering colleges or universities. The reason is that we have not cultivated that spirit of inquiry in the schools. We do not teach practicals the way we should teach practicals. So I can see at least some opportunity. Now, what will happen? What is going to happen is, all those schools who are not examination centers, you will find a rush of everybody applying to become an examination center. And now CBSE had a problem how to find examination centers. And then we have our own jugaad, we'll find out some way to scuttle this. But this is a great opportunity, I think, that there was this particular gap in education. There are schools which do not even buy chemicals. How do they conduct practical examination? For those years that I was there, all I said was, please introduce, instead of practical examination, introduce a paper which is alternative to practicals. It will not be possible for students to solve that paper unless they had actually done practicals in the class.
A couple of years ago it was done in grade 10.
We kept on saying why, when we were suggesting, who were we suggesting for class 12? They implemented it in class 10, it was very convenient. Put two questions of practical examination. So the whole exercise, the whole push was repeated. So I was just mentioning this. There's a lot which is happening, and somebody rang me up and said, everything is not bad, something good is happening. So he mentioned that the new economics book also has reference to GST. So if that is what is happening is, then that means some of these textbooks are being revised and upgraded rather than continue to teach whatever was happening. So hoping that we will take advantage of this situation, and in which the practical examinations will not become a farce in this country, and hopefully the creativity and the spirit of inquiry among the children would develop. Thank you.